Let's review the kinds of timers that are available in an operating system and the pros and cons. The timer that many of you may be familiar with is a periodic timer that is standard in most Unix operating systems. And the periodic timer, the pro is periodicity. That's the pro of a periodic timer, that the operating system is not going to be interrupted willy-nilly, but it is going to be interrupted at regular periods. But the con is the event recognition latency, because the event may have happened at a particular point in time, but because of the granularity of the periodic timer, the event is actually recognized at a much later point in real time. And that's the con for periodic timer. And the maximum timer latency is equal to the period itself. So for instance, if the event happened just after a periodic interrupt, then the event will have to be delivered by the next periodic interrupt. So the worst case latency is going to be the periodicity of the periodic timer itself. The other extreme to periodic timer is what are called one-shot timers. And what one-shot timers are, they are exact timers. That is, you can program these timers to go off at exactly the point at which you want the interrupt to be delivered to the processor. So the pro is the timeliness of the one-shot timer. And secondly, there is also fielding these one-shot timers as and when they occur. That's an extra overhead that the operating system has to deal with. If we are concerned with the interrupt overhead, one extreme position to take is to get rid of timer interrupts altogether and simply use soft timers. That is, there is no timer interrupt, but the operating system is going to poll at strategic times to see if there is an external event. What would be strategic times? Typically, any application is going to make system calls. And when a system call gets you into the kernel, at that point, the kernel can see if there are any events that need attention at that point of time, and that is a polling method. But the downside of the polling method is the fact that there is latency associated with that, and there is also the fact that you have to poll all the events to see if any of them have expired, and there is an overhead associated with that. These are the two cons for a soft timer, but the pro is the fact that you have reduced overhead for soft timers since there are no timer interrupts per se, but the kernel is using strategic points during its execution, such as system calls or other external interrupts, for instance, a network packet arrival or something like that, as a trigger for looking at the timer data structures to see if any of the events may have expired at that point of time. Firm timer is a new mechanism that is proposed in TS Linux, and as we will see shortly, it combines the advantages of all the three timers that I just mentioned, the periodic timer, the one-shot timer, and the soft timer. Essentially, what firm timer is trying to do is take the pros of all of these types of timers in its implementation so that it can avoid the cons associated with each one of these individual choices.